I've noticed you call EMs Cairns. Can someone explain that to me, please?
No thanks, bro.
Hello, friends, and welcome back to Red X, your source for the freshest daily Reddit content. And today, you know very well that we are headed right back into r/entitled parents, the bread and butter of this lovely, lovely channel that we all enjoy so much. We'll jump right into things without any delay with our very first story. She's my sister. It's not what you think, okay? Hey, so I was browsing this sub and remembered something that happened a few years ago. I was like 15 to 16 and I liked this girl in my class, so I went up to her and asked if she wanted to see a movie. She said yes. So that weekend we went to see some crappy movie that I forgot and later went to get lunch at this sandwich joint whose owner I was a friend of. This is where this scene happened. I don't remember exactly what she said, but I got the gist of it. Entitled Mother walks up to us with a crying baby in her arms. Entitled Mother, what is wrong with this generation? OP, do you want to specify? Entitled Mother,
gladly. I hate seeing this everywhere I go. Young people like yourselves getting into relationships. It's so disappointing.
Entitled Mother looking at the girl.
Trust me, honey, men are pigs. My man left me to deal with three kids all on my own. You don't know what you're getting yourself into. Believe me, darling, you're too young to understand the world. You're just going through a phase. What will your parents think of this?
Both of our parents were completely aware and fine with what we were doing. Entitled Mother,
I don't want my kids to grow up in this sinful environment. Please take your stuff somewhere else, darling.
I've had enough of her crap by this point. We had the whole store's attention, like 10 people. OP, I'm sorry to interrupt, ma'am, but she's my sister. We're fraternal twins. We're waiting for our parents. The owner was losing his head behind the counter. It seemed like he was laughing at the woman. Entitled Mother.
Oh, I didn't realize.
Everyone at the store had a sweeping grin on their faces, and the woman awkwardly walked to her car and drove away. Girl to me, I wonder why her man left her. No mystery at all. I think my date liked that because now we're engaged and I plan to propose to her by the end of this whole COVID thing. You're engaged, but you plan to propose? I'm a little confused by that, but okay. Good luck, bro. Anyways, don't get in the way of someone's day because you don't like what you see. I don't think it's just that she didn't like what she saw. I think it's that she doesn't like her life at all. She doesn't want to see anybody happy. Everybody in the world needs to be just as bitter as she is about relationships. I do like the change up though, like instead of trying to convince her that she's wrong, which of course is going to be unsuccessful, you just completely swap things up and you're like, yeah, we're related, I don't know what you're talking about, which is a pretty good tactic. We need to see that used a little more often. But anyways, a nice story, a bit of a twist considering all the other stepbrother and cousin stories that we've had in the last couple days. I like that. So let's jump into the next story. Karen gets her just deserves from a tough-as-nails pregnant woman who I offered my seat to on the train. Just deserves? We got a r/boneappletea right in the title. No shade, though. This was about a year ago. First off, let me say, unlike my last post in this awesome sub, this only involved four people. Me, pregnant lady, black lady, and Karen. A mother of four with probably four different fathers, which entitled her to four different CSA payments, so the lazy, ugly poo head can spend all day sitting on her arse watching Jeremy Kyle. I've noticed you call EMs Karens. Can someone explain that to me, please?
No thanks, bro.
So, it's 5:45, 17:45 on a Friday evening. I'm on a train home after a pretty chilled work day, and I'm looking forward to spending a quiet weekend with my wife and husband. Wife being my actual wife, my husband being my Xbox. It's a marriage of convenience, like Chuck and Larry. So, first stop, New Crossgate. Karen gets on. Her double-barreled pram with the youngest of her brood, the two older ones in front. Noticing the train seats are packed, she rolls her eyes and parks the pram right in front of the doors, so no other passengers can get on or off without having to ask her to move it. She pulls out her tacky-covered iPhone and starts Facebooking, probably moaning that she can't find a seat on the train. So two stops after this, Honor Oak Park, pregnant lady gets on the train. Still no seats, so I stand and say, "Would you like a seat?" To which she replies, thank you so much. I noticed out of the corner of my eye, Karen is triggered. Karen,
excuse me, why didn't you offer me a seat when I got on?
OP, you didn't ask. Karen,
neither did she.
OP, she didn't have to. Karen,
I've got 4 children here. My life is not easy.
I was about to say something back, but pregnant lady decided to jump in. Pregnant lady? Yeah, it must be hard work dragging your fat arse from the bed to the sofa every day. There was a deathly silence, then a few stifled giggles. Opposite where pregnant lady was sitting, a smartly dressed black lady smirked and nodded as to say, well said. Karen's jaw dropped.
Karen, don't you speak to me like that. Who the frick do you think you are?
Pregnant lady, I'm a working mom-to-be who pays her taxes and is equally disappointed as the rest of these working people that their tax money goes towards paying your benefits. I'm also the wife of a hard-working man who also pays taxes and is just as pissed off as I am about you milking the system. Now tell me, who the frickin' hell are you? Karen is now raging. She aggressively walks towards us. My back goes up. I don't make a habit of hitting women, but I will block one who would attack another woman. Unless that woman is my wife, then I'll knock her opponent spark out without a second thought. However, I didn't have to. A smartly dressed black lady stands up and coolly says, go back to your children, and shut the frick up before I turn you inside out. I look at the pregnant lady, she looks at me, guy sitting next to the pregnant lady gets up to get off at the next stop. This is when pregnant lady grabs my arm and literally swings me into the empty seat. Karen looks at the three of us with entitled contempt before leading her kids, none of whom made a comment during the incident, off the train, swearing and muttering under her breath. Black lady sits back down and looks at me. Black lady, you, sir, are a gentleman. I could see that, hence why I jumped in to save you from having to fight her. OP, thank you, I appreciate that. Black lady nods at me and then looks at pregnant lady. And you, darling, that was brilliant what you said. You don't hold back. Pregnant lady, South London, born and bred. Black lady, same here. Both ladies look at me, same here. So, cut a long story short, both ladies left the train at the same stop, leaving me with something to tell my wife when I got home. Now, I'll probably suffer some comments that are like, oh, you're such a horrible person for thinking that, but how did you know that that entitled lady's on benefits? Why would you not offer her your seat? You're a man who's just had a chilled day at work, and you see a lady lugging around 4 kids and you're like, ah, fuck her, she doesn't need a seat. But that pregnant lady definitely does. Bruh, you're the one who doesn't need the seat, so just give it up. I don't understand the line of logic here. Like, yes, the lady with the kids was standing in front of the door, which kinda sucks, but she's only doing that because you wouldn't stand up and give her the seat. Then you want to get on the internet and be like, oh, look at how horrible a person this is. It's like, dude, I'm pretty sure she's doing what basically anybody that's lugging around 4 kids would do. You're the jerk for not giving her the seat and assuming that she was on benefits. And then, of course, you had to shove in some fake dialogue where they called you a gentleman or whatever it is. And then you all nod at each other like, we're from South London. God, it's so cringe-inducing. I won't say it's the worst story that I've read on the sub in a long time, but it definitely stinks. And I know I always put myself out there when I take shots at the OP. I'll probably get some more dislikes on this video than usual, but I gotta say it, you know? Dude needs a reality check for real. Like was the Karen wearing a t-shirt maybe that said, hey, thanks for all the benefits, P.S. all these kids have different dads? You're such a dick for assuming. I really dislike the OP, if you couldn't tell. But I will dwell on it no longer. Let's go ahead and jump into the last story. Entitled mother spent an hour shopping while her child screamed the entire time, then tried to exchange clothes from over a year ago to pay for the clothes she picked out that day. Strapping, y'all. This is my favorite story to share from my time in retail. This lady was absolutely bonkers. It's hella long, but worth the read in my opinion. So, this happened a few years ago, when I was working part-time at a clothing outlet. Let's just say that this company sells higher-end clothing, and caters almost exclusively to Karens. My life was hell for those 2 years. God bless those who work there full-time. You are the real heroes. The cast. Me/OP. Yours truly. EM. Lady who has clearly never interacted with another human being. EK. Her screaming one-year-old. And CO. My poor co-worker. Let me start by saying that this was a Saturday shift in a crowded shopping mall, and I was working a double to cover for a co-worker. I had recently been promoted to shift lead, so I was the manager on duty that day, and was closing. Fast forward to the end of the day was insane, and by the end of it, both my coworker and I were exhausted. We were tidying up the store and taking care of all the go-backs when I heard the door open. It was 8:53. We close at 9. Got 'em. Enter entitled mother and entitled kid. Typically, if we have customers come in that late, it's to grab a gift card or something. We do have the occasional shopper that comes in right before close and stays a while, but they're typically fairly quick when they realize that they're the only ones that are holding us up. Not tonight. The first thing I notice is that entitled kid is screaming. Like, it sounds like someone is ripping his arms off level screams. I walk up to greet entitled mother over the sounds of her screaming offspring. OP. Good evening, ma'am. Is there something I can help you find today? Entitled mother.
No thanks, just browsing.
The worst answer. OP. Well, okay. Let me know if you need help with anything before I close the dressing rooms. My little way of insinuating that it's late and I want to go home. Entitled mother.
Well, I'll definitely need a dressing room. Can you go ahead and start one for me?
Me yelling at this point over the sounds of entitled kids screaming. Sure thing! Entitled mother.
Sorry about him. He's had a long day.
Haven't we all? As I walk away, I notice that entitled mother has a trash bag full of clothes underneath the stroller that is carting around her screaming toddler. Odd, but whatever. Maybe she has a Goodwill donation. For the next hour and a half, this woman tries on every article of clothing in the store. Per corporate policy, we can't rush guests as they shop as long as they come in before close. We tried everything. Turning off the music, sweeping the floor, closing out 2 out of the 3 registers, etc. Pretty much all of the indicators that we are closed and to get the F out. Yet, she stayed. And her kid screamed for an hour of it before he fell asleep. Around 10:30, she's finally ready to check out. I have coworkers start to ring her up so I can get started closing in the back and get us the heck out of here. When I'm in the stockroom, I hear the screams. Trademark copyright 2020. I rush out and I find this lady screaming at coworker, who is one of the nicest people I've ever known and is crying at this point. OP, what seems to be the problem? Anything I can help with? Entitled mother.
Yes, you can fire this idiot because she's treating me like absolute garbage. I don't think corporate will be very happy to hear how their employees are treating paying customers.
Coworker looks at me with tear-filled eyes. Me, coworker, will you go in the back and finish the online orders for me? I'll take care of EM. Okay, ma'am. What can I help you with? Entitled mother.
Well, I was trying to get these clothes returned so I can put the credit towards my purchase.
Entitled mother then takes the full garbage bag of clothes and dumps it out in front of me. Technically, the clothes inside the bag were all from the store where I worked. However, they were all a year older or more. Clearly well worn. No tags. OP. Ma'am, I'm sorry, but you cannot return these. Entitled mother.
What? Why not?
OP. Well, for one, they don't have any tags. You don't have a receipt. And they've clearly been washed and worn by you for quite some time. Returns are typically recent purchases that don't quite fit. Entitled mother.
Well, these don't fit me anymore. so I would like to return them.
You got fat, Karen. Not my fault. Said in a very condescending tone. OP, our return policy is 30 days, and it can't be washed, and you need a tag or receipt. Entitled mother,
can't you just give me store credit?
OP, no, I cannot. You can try to resell shops if you want to, but we are not a thrift store. These pieces aren't even in production anymore. Entitled mother,
I'm not an idiot. I know these clothes are from a while ago because I'm the one who bought them. They don't fit me anymore because I was busy creating human life, and now I need new clothes.
She gestures to her poor, exhausted child, who was at this point woken up and began to scream again. OP, ma'am, I'm sorry, but I still can't accept these as returns. Can I help you purchase the clothes you picked out today? Entitled mother,
like hell you can't. I've had a long day, and I deserve this. I can't afford to buy these without returning my old clothes.
OP, then I don't know what I can do for you. Entitled mother,
you can get me your manager.
OP, full of satisfaction, I'm the manager on the floor tonight. Entitled mother,
well then you are so screwed. I'm calling corporate to report you and co-worker.
OP, here's their number. Call center opens tomorrow at 7 a.m. Entitled mother's mouth dropped. Pretty sure she didn't expect me to be so cavalier about getting reported, but I did not give a single F at this point. She was quiet for a moment and took a deep breath and asked if I could help her bag up her old clothes to take with her so she could give her screaming child a snack. I was pretty shocked at the abrupt mood change, but whatever. I'm exhausted and want to leave so bad. I start bagging up her old clothes, at which point she reached down to grab her kid's snack. As I'm putting the clothes in the bag, she reaches over the counter, grabs the clothes she was going to purchase, and then runs towards the door. I just stand there, because it's against our policy to stop people from shoplifting anyways, and I've locked the doors to prevent other people from coming in. She gets to the doors and violently yanks the handle back and forth, trying to open them. Oh god. I calmly walk over. Entitled mother,
let me out!
OP, sure thing. I hold out my hands for the clothes. She glares at me and then wisely decides it's not worth it. She shoves the clothes at me and turns away, muttering obscenities at me as she does so. I unlock the door and she leaves. As if that encounter wasn't crazy enough, she actually called corporate to complain after literally trying to shoplift from our store. What a wild ride. OP, come on, you can't say that it's a wild ride. That's my line. That's what I get. So, bye-bye.